This man's name cannot appear in public. He's been thrown into prison more than once. He's been mentally and physically tortured. This is Burma's ruling elite. They run one of the world's most repressive regimes. This man is dangerous. He dares to speak out against the regime. He is Burma's leading comedian. This dictatorship is unflinching in suppressing any threat. They will ruthlessly hunt down any dissidents. I filmed this man in 2007. His name is Zarganar. Zarganar has been a comedian for over 25 years, but he doesn't just tell jokes. He uses satire fearlessly to expose government corruption and injustice. In this performance from 1990, Zarganar imitates Burma's first modern dictator, General Ne Win. Five years earlier, he'd been summoned into the lion's den to give a special performance in front of the dictator himself. He defied warnings not to tell political jokes in a most extraordinary way.
Before I start my performance, I used this plaster, the plaster, and seal my lip, and then I get into the stage. So Unewin asks me, hey, why Zarganar took that plaster to paste his lip? So I reply them, they want me not to tell any political jokes, and Mr. Dictator Ne Win, he laughed.
But Ne Win's laughter was false and turned into a threat. Zarganar was told, do that again and you'll end up in prison. Zarganar ignored it.
The people cry, we cry. People laugh, we laugh. People hate, we hate. So we must stand in front of the people.
Reflect the people.
Yeah, and we must sacrifice for the people.
September 2007, the Saffron Revolution begins. Thousands of Buddhist monks lead protests against the regime. Zarganar publicly supports the monks. The result? 3 weeks in prison. The government responds to the uprising with overwhelming force. To this day, no one knows how many were killed. April 2008, Burma's worst natural disaster, Cyclone Nargis. Reports estimate 200,000 people dead or missing. The Burmese junta is condemned all over the world for preventing the distribution of foreign aid. Zarganar organizes his own relief effort. He gives interviews to foreign media and speaks out of the junta's indifference to the suffering of the people.
They are very angry to the military junta because they didn't get any food. They didn't get anything from the military junta. And some kinds of revenge they want to make.
This broadcast and other interviews he gives to the world infuriates the regime. In June 2008, Zarganar is arrested again. In November, he is convicted of offences against public order and a trumped-up charge of violating the Electronics Act. The sentence, 59 years in prison. I'm Rex Blumstein, and I'd met and filmed Zarganar in 2007, the year before he was sent to jail. I was incensed when I heard about his 59-year sentence and determined to use my experience as a documentary filmmaker to highlight this injustice. I tried to raise funds to make a film based on this unseen footage, but no one was interested. It was the end, or so I thought. But then, out of the blue, on a cold winter's morning in my house in London, the phone rang. I found myself speaking to one of Germany's most famous comedians, Michael Mittermeier. Hello! He'd heard about my project and wanted to talk. I said to myself, a comedian from Germany?
There is no German comedian. All the rest of the world thinks there is no humor in Germany. And so a German comedian, it would be like, I don't know, a cockroach cleaning up the kitchen.
Ich habe mich drüben auf dem Times Square, habe ich mich auf eine Kiste gestellt und gesagt, danke Amerika, danke! 60 Jahre lang hat die ganze Welt uns Deutsche gehasst. Alle haben gesagt, der ewige Nazi kommt wieder. 60 Jahre lang, seit ihr Amerikaner den Irak angegriffen habt, hasst die Welt Amerika mehr als uns Deutsche. Danke, Amerika! Danke! Hey! Wir sind raus aus dem Hass-Business! Wir sind wieder frei! Wir sind die Guten!
When I go abroad somewhere, I also go there as a German. We say, fuck you, I'm funny. So sit and laugh. You wouldn't believe it, but you will laugh.
I like your national team. They move, wow, they move so cool. It's like, you go, but there are no goals. You just look good. Do it like we Germans. Go.
But why would a German comedian be interested in a Burmese comedian?
Nobody knows there are comedians in Burma. Nobody knows there are comedians in Germany. It's kind of, we share something together. And but when I heard about that, he's in prison because just what he was saying, his lines, his political jokes, that shows me, because I share a little bit the spirit that I think comedy is more than just laughs. Comedy can open the mind, the hearts. And so for me, comedy is, it's my life.
Aber lustig.
I was in Burma 5 years ago, and it's, I think, the most beautiful country I ever saw in my life. And I'm supporting a charity organization here in Germany. They support Burmese people, orphans, and they build schools and this. And so, I don't know, I think it's not a coincidence that some English director came to me, asked me about, hey, I have this film with Zarganar. Are you interested in perhaps being in producing and look at the material? And I said to him, yeah, did you know that I support Burma since years? No. And then it's kind of, it's weird. It's not a coincidence, I think.
Michael's support meant that we could make a film about Zarganar. All the footage he was about to see was filmed over 2 days in April 2007, beginning in Zarganar's flat.
Tell us who you are.
Yes, my name is Zarganar, and I'm a comedian of Burma.
Hey!
This is a notorious Zarganar. This is a very good futur, so I like it. Everybody can satire also to me. This is me. When I took a graduation paper, and this is my rector. And when I got a graduation paper. So I'm a dentist. But I cannot extract any tooth because I forgot all. I don't want to be a dentist. I want to be a comedian, because the comedian blood is flow into my body, and I like to make some jokes to laugh to every people. And when I make a dentist, a professional dentist, and I can only open his mouth, only mouth, and when I make some jokes, many people open their mouth. So I like and I love, and so I changed my life. I changed my profession from the dentist to the comedian life. So I love comedian life. I took the name Zarganar. So because I took the name Zarganar, it means in the dental clinic, we use the tweezer. You mean tweezer? It's just like that. In our Burmese words, a tweezer is like the Zarganar. And also another word is in our Burmese tradition. It's a very difficult to translate, but I try to translate. That word is "chao mui ba Zarganar ne no." So it means if you fear, that fear will be exerted by the Zarganar. This is our Burmese traditional words. So I took that name for me. My name is Zarganar.
Zarganar knew the risks of being filmed in a country full of informers and paid agents of the state. But nothing would stop him telling jokes about the government.
American Lumio, English Lumio, ကျွန်တော်တို့ဟိုဗမာလူမျိုးရဲ့၃ယောက်ကတွေ့ကြပါလေရောဗျာအဲ့ဘာသူကဘာသူတည်းပိုကြွားတယ်လဲဆိုတာကိုအဲ့ဒီမှာပြန်ရလာဟောအမေရိကန်လူမျိုးကစကြွားတယ်ဗျာအဲ့တော့ဘယ်လိုကြွားတော့ဟေးတို့အမေရိကန်ကွာခြေထောက်တစ်ဖက်မရှိဘူးနော်အေးဟောဒီခြေထောက်တစ်ဖက်မရှိဘဲနဲ့အေးဝရက်တောင်ပေါ်ကိုတက်တာနှစ်ခါရှိသွားပြီအမေရိကန်ကြွားတယ်အဲ့ဒီကကျတော့ဘယ်အင်္ဂလိပ်ကလည်းဘယ်နေမလဲဒီအင်္ Lenna Pemashibu. Atlantic Modia, who betting, debating, Nakaupia Kubi do Avigual. That English quality. Addition Jarama, Pama, Payam. Come here, American, English, Lado. Thanare. A chime, hey, Dima, Pama, qua. Time be Ocho da session Nishi do Avi. Kongu Mishibu. That's all.
He's so funny, and he's telling it so lightly, and then at the end there comes, and that's why he's so dangerous for the military regime, because he's on the point.
What about this interview that you and I are doing? What is the risk for you for talking to me? you're not allowed to talk to a foreign media like me, yes?
Yes, that.
You're banned from talking to me.
Yeah. And that is, I think that is their opinion. That is their side. But at my side, I can talk everybody. I can freely interview with any foreigner or any foreign radio or any foreign TV station. This is my right. I must stand for my rights. If they told or if they make some punishment to me, I will defend on my rights. I make many films, many video movies, and many TV advertisements. And then, 2006, last year, Tinjan Festival, I have some interview with BBC. They don't like it, and then they ban me again.
I read that the Burmese people, they try to laugh away the pain. So when they say something painful or they have something painful, they laugh over it. So it's kind of, it's not that he's just saying, yeah, I don't care. He cares a lot.
I'm banned from to participate in the movie, or I'm banned from making the performance on stage. I'm banned from talking the voice from the radio, and I'm banned from the writing on the journals or magazine. And also they didn't allow my name in any printing media.
He's not even allowed to write his name on paper. This is a torture of the mind, because if I write some lines and someone would give it to the police, they would arrest me. It's I can't imagine being in a situation like this.
This is my room. This is my bed. And then this is my computer. I use my computer to type, to write some screenplay, and to raw edit. And then there is my family photo. Yeah, this is my son, me, my wife, my daughter, and my dog, Nippy, at the Junta beach. That is the last photo of our family.
Zarganar had already been imprisoned 3 times for his opposition to the government when he insisted his family live abroad. He told me of his last and longest prison sentence, where he spent 5 years in solitary confinement after being tortured continually for 7 days.
Never get sound sleep. When I start to sleep, they pour the water to me and they ask me to stand, and they beat and they kick, and sometimes they use some rubber pipe. They use a rubber pipe to beat my back and my belly. I passed 5 years lonely. I only heard the voice and sound of the man or woman or birds or any sounds. I cannot see anybody. Some of my friends in that jail, they try to kill themselves. They try to kill themselves. And some bodies are very angry, and they are very sensitive. So I saw that. I myself think, I don't want to die in here, and I don't want to meet in prison. I want to get out. I want to release from the prison with good brain and good health. So I try to maintain my mind, and I try to maintain my health. For example, there is many songs from the loudspeakers that we can listen. I can hear that song. So I I like to make some musical notes. For example, that song is for a very famous song from the dead at that time. La la so la so la do la so mi re re mi la la. So many time I sing a song and I touch the musical notes. Then I got the willpower. I think when I heard one song, automatically that musical note is coming out from my mouth. So many time, repeatedly, I train myself. So this is a very strange thing. All of my friends felt that strange, because when I release from the insane jail, I can sing the musical notes. Every song.
When you grow up as a German, you always have this in mind, the dictatorship, the Nazi regime. So when I hear his story about being in prison during now a dictatorship, and he's a comedian, I'm a comedian, but now in a free Germany. So there are these thoughts. What would I do? Would I have done something like Zarganar? And even in Germany, in the younger history, with the Socialist Party in the DDR, it was the same. You could not express just your humor and your comedy freely on stage. So I always will be with this history, and that's surely something, point that in interests me a lot, when a comedian really stands up. And I like the word stand-up comedian, because at this point it means he's standing up and confronting them.
I don't like revenge and hatred. For example, me and the military regime, now they ban me, but I don't hate them. I don't hate them. The important thing is the enemies must be my friend. This is my opinion. All enemies must be my friend.
Saying my enemy should be my friend, because I can just persuade my friend. I cannot persuade an enemy. This is a very Buddhist style of thinking and feeling. He's not just thinking it, he feels it. He means it. For him, it's a fact.
Our country's people, our Burmese people, they have many feelings in their deep of heart. There are many feelings, there are many words in their bottom of heart, but they're afraid of. They don't dare to criticize, they don't dare to speak aloud. So I am their loudspeaker. So I am represent their hearts. So I told the jokes, I make the jokes for them. So they pleased. And they want they think they want to change. They want to change their own society by means of their open heart. So I think like that.
So where do you get your courage from?
Courage? I think, sir, I got the... I think this is not a courage, this is an ordinary people's spirit, I think.
You asked him, are you courageous? And he doesn't even know what you're talking about. Me, I'm courageous? No, why? We would say he's a hero. He is what he's doing, but he doesn't even understand the question, because for him it's normal.
So you've survived prison. Yeah. You can survive anything.
Yes, this is the beauty of survival. They don't like me because I am the stimulator, I am the agitator, and I am the organizer, so they don't like me.
Zarganar wanted to show me the places where he was banned. It was impossible for us to film in the streets without being spotted by informers. So we decided to travel through Yangon by car.
can't we see the military or the police?
But some police are also they mix with the military.
But they're not in the streets.
They'd be behind the street, beside the street, in the street, at the corner, everywhere we can see there.
Are they plain clothes or are they in uniform?
Some are in uniform, some are in normal clothes, and we can see everywhere, anywhere. And they're sitting, they're standing, they're walking on the road.
But you can't get out of the car. We can't be seen to film you, can we?
If I get out from the car, everybody can see there is a Zarganar, and also there is the informer and the surveillance and police. They can make some troubles, and they can keep your camera, and they will ask so many questions. Now, I'd like to show you, this is a cinema hall, and then the King Cinema Hall, and then this is a Twin Cinema Hall, and Sutupan Cinema Hall, and Myuma Cinema Hall, and Shui Kong Cinema Hall. There are many cinema halls in there, but I'm not allowed to participate, or I'm not allowed to perform in any movie. That's banned.
Can you show your films at all?
Now I can show you any
films. No films at all?
No films.
Hugely popular and much loved, Zarganar has been a major film star in Burma for many years. He's a writer, producer, actor, director. His films, shows and commercials have mass appeal and have played all over the country. He occupies a special place in the hearts of the people.
This is Pansonan Street. The whole street is a bookstall. You can see the bookstall.
Zarganar has written poems, books, articles, and even his screenplays are published. But you won't find any of them in these bookstalls. All are now banned by the state censors.
Shall we stop outside a bookstore, or is it too dangerous?
I think it's dangerous because this is a security,
right.
A security branch office. I think it's a police station.
Zarganar had arranged for us to meet his fellow comedians. They were using a hall in the local YMCA as a makeshift studio to record a one-act play written by an unnamed playwright. Guess who?
Some of the plays are written by me. I wrote some play. So we will go and we will visit to their shooting. So you will see their shooting, how to shoot in Burma.
Shall we hide our camera?
But no, not to hide.
Not to hide.
Not to hide. Not to hide.
Okay. All right.
I'd like to introduce you to my old friends.
But we won't say why we're here. We'll just say that we're your friends, yes?
Yes.
You would prefer us not to say why we're here.
Yeah, right. You are my friends, and I like to show you the shootings of our Burma. So,
okay.
You can hear the voice, the Burmese drum voice.
We'll keep running.
Yeah.
Now we were about to see his friends performing on stage. I wondered how he would react. Would he feel compelled to take the risk and get on the stage himself?
We are now on reaching the YMCA Hall.
At first, there were the introductions.
His name is Belua.
Belua.
Very charming face.
Yes.
Yes. He looks like E.T., you know?
E.T.?
E.T., extraterrestrial. Yeah.
Extraterrestrial.
No, E.T.
E.T. by Spielberg. His name is Godzilla.
Godzilla?
Yeah.
Godzilla. Godzilla.
I think I've already told you about his name, the sound of the cat. Meow.
Meow.
Meow. This is
meow. Meow. Yes. Yes.
Oh, no, yeah. His name is Apple.
Apple.
Yeah.
Hello.
He's also one of my friends, and his name is Fried Banana.
Fried Banana?
Yeah.
That's fried. Your name?
Yes. It's a Fried Banana. You would like to eat? His name is Button.
Button, yes. Yeah. Button, yes.
Yeah, yeah, Button.
There's a great name for comedians here.
Yes, I give the name to them. Button and Apple and... Button, Apple, and Diamond Ring.
Fried Banana.
Fried Banana, and Meow.
Meow.
Yes. I give the name for them.
It all seemed so light-hearted, as if this was a normal rehearsal and recording. But then Zarganar told me something that made me realize the danger he was in.
The security and the guard of that hotel, that YMC, they are now watching us, right, behind you. And if I get on the stage, they will come to there. They will object.
Now I understood why Zarganar could not go on that stage. But there was also another reason.
They signed a contract when they rent this hall that Zarganar should not get on that stage. They signed that contract. So I keep their promise. I can stand in front of the stage. Here. I can stand here, but I cannot get on the stage. I think it's important for us because
The 2 days I had spent with Zarganar revealed to me his courage and commitment in the face of total censorship. 18 months later, he would be sentenced to 59 years in prison.
Sir, we're going to leave you.
Yeah. I'm very happy to meet you, but I felt very sorry not to perform you from on stage because I'm not allowed to perform on stage.
Yeah. So this sums up freedom of expression in Myanmar.
Yeah, so this is a good example for the freedom of expression in our country.
Or the lack of it.
Yeah. And so I think I'd like to perform you and your friends from stage one day later.
Thank you. Good luck. I hope we see each other again.
Yeah.
I never did see him again.
For me now, sitting here imagining that he's now there in prison and under the lowest and worst conditions you can imagine. This is a farce, giving him 59 years. If we could talk a little bit, that would be great.
So do you want to go to Burma?
Definitely. I have to go to Burma. I have to try to come as near as I can get to him. Perhaps it's kind of spirit we can share when I'm in Burma. I don't know. I wanna understand more from him. And I think I have to go to the country where he lived and where he lives.
So the decision was made. Michael felt, as I did, that we had to make people aware of Zarganar's tragedy. But what could we do? We knew the military regime would never allow us to visit Zarganar, but once in Burma, we could talk to those who knew him. Burma is one of the most controlled and censored countries in the world. We ran the risk of being arrested, as did Zarganar's friends and colleagues if they went on camera. Nevertheless, a number had agreed to speak out. We would meet them over the next few days. We traveled as tourists with small cameras to avoid attention.
Only 2 years ago, there was blood on these streets. You see this place and you see where the people were shot, were killed. And the Zarganar was a part of this story also, because also the Zarganar was arrested after the uprising from 2007. He was released and then brought to prison again later on. But we are now in the, it's not just a story, we are now in a living story. We are this,
Our first interviews were going to be in Zarganar's flat, where I'd filmed him in 2007. But on our way, we received a call that the people we wanted to film had backed off. We were very disappointed, but at least Michael would see Zarganar's home. We thought the flat was being watched, so we couldn't turn up all together in a car. We went to a cafe nearby and decided to enter the flat one by one, straight and fast, and go quickly up the stairs to be seen by few residents. I thought once inside, we couldn't be seen and were safe.
You can still feel that he was here. It's it's filled with his, I would say, energy and his life. And this picture, I have to do this now as a notorious. It sounds funny, but it's. It's getting real, and there's more in it. When he said just I'm notorious, it was, yeah, he said it with a smile and like the comedian, but now he's in prison, and yeah, and that's one part of being notorious here in Burma. And so I would like to see him in person. It's so sad.
Looking at Zarganar reminded me of his concern at the conditions in which people lived in Burma. What did the generals care if the people had only a few hours of electricity a day? Zarganar had a joke for that one.
Hey, my name is Yaruma. Do a gong yama, the coat of the family to Arabia. Ame? The coat will look be family to Arabia. She said, oh, hey, the egg, the yak will look me, I'm a lot of mom, man. မဲနေတဲ့အချိန်မှာတခုကဘယ်အချိန်တုန်းကလည်းမသိဘူးအိမ်ထဲရောက်ပြီးတော့မျက်နှာချက်မှာတက်ပုံးနေတာအဲ့ဒီအချိန်မှာဂျုံဆိုလက်စစ်မီလဲလာလဲလာရောဘွားကနေတရက်ကလုံးကလင်းသွားတော့တခိုးကလည်းအပေါ်ကကြည့်ပြီးဝန်းတာပြီးတော့မိလာပြီဟေးမိလာပြီဟေးမိလာပြီဟေးဆိုတခိုးကအော်ပြီးတော့ပြေးဆင်းလာတာအဲ့ဒီတခိုးအဖမ်းခံလိုက်ရပါလေဗျာ second version yes yeah
there is no electricity here right now and this is the place where he worked and they took it's just the screen they took the computer they took all what they from this what he had for storage for computer and this
the police
took it away so that's all what is left he's braver than I don't know most of the comedians in the world because he really took a risk
by now the person helping us our fixer was becoming increasingly nervous and several times urged us talk more silent as he listened through the door for footsteps on the staircase outside
It's a state of constant fear. That's not what you can feel when you're outside of the country. When I looked at the footage, you read the books, you know it, you read it, but you hear, and then you feel it. That everybody's looking and everybody is, or who is watching, and this is. And we cannot go outside and film just like we film here. It would be very dangerous. And that's what I forgot before I came here. And when we drove here, it's for the first time I realized it really. So that's. Outside of the apartment, here was Zarganar standing. I cannot stand long because they said it's dangerous, and so it's feeling really weird to feel that perhaps you stay a few minutes too long, they will see you, and someone will call someone, and so.
We left the building in two groups. It seemed melodramatic to us, but to our fixer, the spy-like tactic was an everyday occurrence for people in this country, something you did to avoid the chances of arrest or prison. Who could tell who were the informers? Time to be tourists.
I came a lot nearer to Zarganar, and standing in his flat, I was glad being there, but also it was tragic that he's not there. We cannot talk to him, so we have to talk to people who know him, but they don't talk to us, most of them, because they are in fear. yeah, I think I learned a lot about this country, how this is working, this constant surveillance, the constant pressure. They're everywhere, and it's, and he, when we were in the apartment, that our guy who led us there, every few minutes went to the door and listened, oh, someone is coming. And this was not just a show, this was real. He was in fear.
Over the next few days, we met with people who told us so much more about Zarganar. How important and influential he was in Burma. How he used humour to make ordinary people dare to think about politics. In this excerpt from a TV show in 1987, it seems that Zarganar and his fellow comedians are celebrating Burmese independence. What Zarganar is really doing is calling for an end to General Ne Win's military dictatorship. In 1988, economic collapse triggered the country's biggest revolt. We were told that Zarganar's jokes and satire had helped and encouraged people to speak out.
Do you think your jokes have the power to change things?
To change things? So, it's, accurately, I don't think so. But they ignite the brain of the people. And when they got the light, they will try to change.
We were now halfway through our trip, and our project was facing disaster. Every single person we hoped would go on camera to talk about Zarganar was too frightened. So we decided to find the hall where Zarganar has so proudly introduced me to friends and fellow comedians, where I'd seen him for the very last time. Michael had only ever seen this place on film. I myself never thought I would visit here again. How painful must it have been for Zarganar to see his friends performing and not be allowed to perform himself on stage?
Yeah, it's the same stage, same place, and it's amazing being here because you see it in the film, but now it's real. It was standing there, and the line in between here and going up, it was for us just like, yay. Someone would say, step up the stage, not a problem. But it was really this big, big, big line he couldn't cross. Da, da, da. I remember all this performance. It was so. Like I said, there's so the Asian comedy, the stage, it's so full of energy and always shouting. No, you would have been, that would be fun to do comedy here with audience, Burmese audience, whatever audience. So, joke number one. I'm standing here in the YMCA. Thank you very much. It was a great pleasure. And we see us at the Academy Awards.
So we're here in the YMCA building. I think we're relatively safe to talk, but I feel like you, this is a utterly deceptive society. I don't know who is watching or when or even why. What I do know is that we can be picked up at any time, like anybody else in this country. But we can leave. You and I can leave.
That's one of their biggest things they have in their hands. They take away the visas, the passports, like we know from one guy we met, one actor. They just take the passport, so they cannot leave the country. He's not just a comedian, but he's part of the big history here in Burma. It was very interesting that when we spoke to two famous actors, directors, and they all said the same. The dictator and the military, they have fear about the actors, about the artists, because they speak for the people and many people listen to them. That's kind of this what Zach said. He's a loudspeaker. And it was kind of today when we heard that many people believe that Zarganar was one of the big factors of the 1988 uprising. He did this. He did this. He knew when I'm the only one. He was the first political comedian who did this. He started this. It was not a movement of, I don't know, 100 actors going for against the company. He was the one who said, I do it. This joke. He started this. And I was alone in jail, so it's
The Shwedagon Pagoda is a place of innocence and spirituality. It's also where Zarganar supported the monks in their doomed struggle for a different Burma, for the children of this country. We could do no more in Yangon. But there was one last thing we felt we ought to do. We should try and film the prison the Zarganar was in.
Now to Mijina, and I'm excited because it's the nearest place we can get to Zach. It's the town where in the near he's held captive, and tomorrow is his 50th birthday, so it's kind of, we feel it's, yeah, good energy being there, as near as we can get. We will see what will happen. Perhaps some people will talk to us, perhaps we can get near to the place and at least perhaps send him a good energy. And so it's gonna be exciting. And we go with the Amber Gun. world known air bagan. There are two sayings. Never fly air Myanmar. And the second is never fly air bagan. You should even fly, make a balloon flight over bagan more than do air bagan. So we are second choice. Thanks to this wonderful team, that they are always choosing the best airlines.
Well, we all have our different ways of dealing with tension. As I was beginning to realize, for Michael, there's always humor. How difficult would it be to film the prison? What were the risks? We are to meet our fixers to discuss this. We've been told about a man who might get a message to Zarganar himself, and we'll meet him in the evening. Michael called him Mr. China. Whilst we wait, we need to keep up our pretense of posing as tourists in Machina. Michina is the largest city in Kachin State, home to one of the biggest ethnic groups in Burma. It's in the north, and 1,000 miles from the former capital, Yangon, and 100 miles from the Chinese border. We wait in Michina's night market for news of Mr. China, who we hope will get a message to Zarganar. He doesn't appear.
It's a mobile disco!
This is a very odd place, like the Wild West. No streetlights, drugs for sale. And what we thought was a mobile disco turned out to be a plug for your friendly neighborhood downtown pagoda.
So that's the boiling corn. This petrol. Yeah, there's a gas station for cars. It's for car driving. This petrol. Yeah, gas. Yeah. It's gas.
This is a gas station.
Yeah. Do we need some? Does Shell know that they are here?
Our journey to the prison began. We'd already discussed with our fixers the dangers of being arrested and the trouble this might cause them or even Zarganar himself. But on balance, we all felt getting footage of Zarganar's jail and revealing this to the world was more important.
I wonder why Zarganar was sent so far away from Yangon.
It's very hard to come here. Plane ticket, very expensive. And by train, it's horrible. Bus, not possible. And so it's very hard for people to visit him. But what is great, that the people we talk to here, they all know Zach. They talk about him, they know his humor. They tell his jokes. So it's kind of... He's in the people's mind. So it's great to hear. So he lives on. His wit is living on. And this is Nobody can stop this.
Prison road is coming up now.
The nearer we got to the prison, the higher the stakes and the greater our tension. Should we gamble everything and get as close as possible? Should we continue filming but drive on? In the end, we thought it safest not to get too near, so we decided to stop on the open public road where we thought suspicions might be less.
This is it, I think. Michael, yeah. This is the prison. This is where Zag is.
Yeah, it's just a few hundred yards away.
Beyond this building, there is the black wall, you know? Do you see?
Beyond these buildings is the prison walls.
I wonder how is he feeling now? Is he suffering? It's would be good to know whether he's in good shape or at least his mind is in good shape, like he said before. It's very important to keep the mind up. And but it's so near. You think, yeah, we just go there and say, can we visit Zag and just like say hello? But it's near, but it's like worlds apart. It's worlds apart. I sometimes ask myself whether he tries to make the prisoners laugh, to release the situation. Would feel good to me if he's really keeping up the spirit, perhaps of other people too. And there was this joke. You just this is, it's hard to translate. And but it was like when children, they're boiling corn. Boiling corn is called pew corn. I don't know the word, but word for corn in Burmese, pew. But pew can also mean that you're dismissed, you lose your job. So people pew corn, and somebody said, Sagana, do you want to pew corn? It's like, no, let the generals and the military guys pew. So he said, not just boil the corn, he said, let them pew the corn, because then they dismiss themselves. So they pew. And that's how he does his humor. It's always like it's a word, double meaning, and it can be like childish, but it's very political. And he told this in prison. And people got it out of the prison, and they tell it around here. And so he's there. And that's a good thing to know, that it's not just like he's in prison and forgotten. I would like to go there.
We thought this was as close as we would ever get to Zarganar and the end of our journey. Our emotions were wrung out. All thoughts of arrest had disappeared. We felt frustration and disappointment. We needed to get away. We travelled 30 miles from Michina to the place where all tourists go to experience the beginning of Burma's great waterway, the Irrawaddy, where the Unmai and Mali rivers meet. It felt where we needed to be.
What a nice place. Get some air. It's not that we're getting too serious on this day, just like, and
Yeah. It's... Want to make a toast for Zarganar's 50th birthday?
Zarganar.
Hopefully, happy birthday and. I have a retake. No, I have one retake.
Okay.
Another. Now, from this time on, every 5 seconds, some kind of hey-yo, helicopters flying in the Rojong, tanks driving around. We're gonna make a toast to you, Zarganar, to your 50th birthday. But where are you? We're waiting here for you since hours. We throw here the big party at the hero body, so please
make an appearance.
Yeah, he would like this joke.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, if he doesn't, he can't do very much about it.
He will just hear this joke when he's out of prison, so it's kind of then he can beat me up. You can beat me up for this. I'm your German supporting comedian, so you can do all what you want to. Just do this. I'm glad I came here because everybody knows him, everybody loves him. And everybody tells jokes from him. That's amazing. And that's, you can just learn here. We heard yesterday this, that even when he went out of the train, the transport to the prison, he was transported here with the train. And when he went out of the train and went up to the prison car, a lot of people were standing around and he addressed the people. He said something to the people. Because, and I have to explain, because it's always with these double meanings. He got 50 years sentence in jail.
59 years.
59 years, yeah, 59 years. And normally when you make an exam or something like this, with 80%, with 80 you get your distinction. So he went out of the train and said to the people, oh, 59. I didn't even get distinction. So, how can you do this? Being funny on your way to 59 years of prison. And that would be one of my questions I would have to you, Sam.
That evening, we finally meet our contact, Mr. China. We give him a message Michael has written to Zarganar.
Dear Zed, my name is Michael and I'm a comedian from Germany. I'm here in Mitchina with Rex on your 50th birthday. We are thinking of you and send you our love. I hope I can be your loudspeaker. Michael.
Mr. China also tells us the Zarganar is in a cell not with fellow dissidents, but former intelligence officers, now out of favor with the regime. What could be more ironic? The hunted locked together with the hunters. All this new information about Zarganar increased our frustration at not getting better footage of the prison. So how could we do it without risking arrest? Our fixer offered a solution. Everybody here rides a bike. Why not Michael with his own camera? We considered the risks and agreed. Once again, the comedian in Michael was at work.
Dear audience, I know what you're thinking. You're watching this documentary and think, well, where's the action? They're just talking and talking and talking. So, there has to, at least, there has to be one action scene in a movie, and it's coming now. Now I'm gonna be the action man. This is my horns doing the action. I get now with a motorcycle. We go a little bit nearer to the prison with a motorcycle. And I've just one problem. I cannot drive motorcycle. I never drove motorcycle in my life. So I have a motorcycle driver, but I'm the action man in the rear. So Zach, this one's for you. I think you will gonna like it. Where's my music? My dramatic music should be like. So, let's go and get some action. Yes.
Agreed that when approaching the prison, we would go in opposite directions to avoid suspicion, and we would wait for Michael to complete his journey.
And this is where some military people are living.
Oh, soldiers. Oh, yeah. Put the camera down.
Yes,
put the camera down.
Okay.
On the right side is the prison.
There's the prison, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. He's going to turn right in a minute, isn't he?
We turn left. We're turning left, and he's turning right.
Okay, so watch him go.
We go there a little bit nearer with the motorcycle.
You see the wall?
Yeah, see the wall.
But we cannot turn to the right. We can continue to the left.
Yeah, I know.
And then you see that the signboard is signboard you can look also.
So this is the gate of the prison.
Prison the gate. You see?
So for the first time we see really footage from the prison. This is the prison area.
Right, prison area.
This is the prison wall. Yeah, so Zach's behind this walls. It's so near, but it's so far. Oh, perhaps I never come nearer to him again. It's hard to reflect this. Can we stop for a second here, or is it dangerous to? So we go on. We go on.
So that you discuss and you can follow. So that you make the plan.
Yeah.
Michael returns safely. No one seemed to have noticed him on the bike with his little camera.
I hope the camera worked, the camera I had with me. So there should be footage, very shitty made, but there should be footage of the prison wall, the watchtowers and the gate. And he's daring. He's saying perhaps we go a second time and you can follow very long after us, so but it's really, I kind of feel him.
Michael had been using a small domestic camera, but now our fixer was suggesting going back to film with our better quality camera, and this was a risk.